السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، وبعد، أيها الإخوة والأخوات، Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, my topic right now about the obedience of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The obedience of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, it's essential and mandatory upon each Muslim brother and sister. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran in many verses, many ayat. One of these ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ وحسن أولئك رفيقا ذلك الفضل من الله وكفى بالله عليما. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and who obeys Allah and the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then they will be in the company of those on whom Allah has bestowed his grace, of the prophets, the siddiqeen, the shuhada, martyrs, the salihin, the righteous and pious people. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah An-Nisa, مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولِ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ. Whoever obeys the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he obeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who told us, who command us to obey his prophet, his messenger Muhammad, peace be upon him. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that if we obey Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if we obey Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we will be guided. وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. If you obey Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will be guided. It means that whoever does not obey Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he will be misguided. وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. If you obey Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will be guided. The most amazing thing that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in an authentic hadith, كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة. كل أمتي يدخلون الجنة. All of my Muslim ummah will enter paradise. إلا من أبى, except for those who refuse. Who can refuse to enter paradise? The Sahaba asked the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, من أطاعني دخل الجنة ومن عصاني فقد أبى. When the Sahaba, the companions, asked Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, who will refuse to enter paradise, O Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, whoever obeys me, he will enter Jannah, he will enter paradise. And whoever disobeys me, he will refuse to enter paradise. So it's so simple, so easy to enter Jannah if we obey Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If someone did not obey Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he by himself refused to enter paradise. So the most direct and shortest and straight way to the paradise, to the Jannah, the obedience of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever they command us to do something, they always command us to do what will benefit us. In all kind of commandments, orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it will benefit us. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not get any benefits from our obedience. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself will not get any benefits, any materialistic benefits from obeying, from the obedience from us to him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever he commanded us to do something, whenever Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded us to do something, it's for ourselves. من اهتدى فإنما يهتدي لنفسه. ومن ضل فإنما يضل عليها ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى وما كنا معذبين حتى نبعث رسولا. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Isra, whoever became guiding, he will benefit himself. It's for himself. And whoever went astray, it will be against himself. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need anything from us. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't need anything from us. But we need to obey Allah and obey Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in order to protect ourselves from the hellfire in the akhirah, in the day of judgment, and from any hardship, from any affliction, from any bad results, bad issues, if we disobeyed Allah or disobeyed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let me give you a story happened at the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As it was mentioned in an authentic hadith, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was eating with someone. And that person started eating using his left hand. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded him to use his right hand. Eat with your right hand, not left hand. The man refused out of pride and arrogance. He refused to listen and to obey the order, the commandment of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, out of arrogance and pride. So he refused. He said, I cannot use my right hand. He's telling a lie. He can, but he insisted to refuse. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he knew from him that out of his pride and arrogance, he refused to listen to him and obey his order, he said to him, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not enable you to use your right hand. So from that moment, that person could not use his right hand. He could not raise his right hand to his mouth after that, because he refused to obey Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So whoever refused to obey Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will prevent himself from entering paradise in the akhirah, in the jannah, in the day of judgment. And in this dunya, he will hurt and harm himself. So we have to, if we are real believers, we have to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obey the orders, the commandments of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, especially the mandatory act of worship, the fara'id, the mandatory act of worship. We have to perform this mandatory act of worship on its proper time. And to get away, to be away, far away from the major sins, especially the major sins, the kaba'ir. That's the most important kind of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or much important than any other sunnah. The whole sunnah is very important, but not more important than the mandatory act of worship and being away from the major sins. So the action items that I advise myself to do and advise all of you, my dear respected beloved brothers and respected sisters, is to do your best to apply and perform the mandatory act of worship, whether in salah, prayer, 5 daily prayers, siyam, Ramadan, fasting Ramadan, giving the mandatory zakah, performing hajj, the mandatory hajj, if you did not do it till now, and to always remind yourself with saying, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, the shahadatin. Then any mandatory act of worship in the aspect of manners, behaviors, akhlaq, mu'amalat, transactions with your parents, with your husband, with your wife, with your family members, with your brothers, Muslim brothers and Muslim sisters, and being away from any kind of major sins. Any kind of major sins. like shirk billah, associating other with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most miserable major sins. Disobeying or dishonor your parents, it's major sins. Dealing with riba, interest, usury, it's a major sins. Not performing the salah, the mandatory salah, on its proper time, it's a major sins, and so on. So this is my advice to myself first, then to all of you. جزاكم الله خيرا تقبل الله منا ومنكم يا الله سبحانه وتعالى make you all and us all from those who obey Allah and Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم جزاكم الله خير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.